Assalamualaikum dear students, today we are going to solve the problem set 15. Problem set 15, chapter number 4, multiplication and division. See the question number 1. Solve the following and write the quotient and remainder. Here we have to solve the questions and we have to find the quotient and remainder. So see, the first one is 1284 divided by 32. Here we have to divide 1284 by 32. So the dividend is 1284 and the divisor is 32. So for that, first we prepared the table of 32. Here I have already prepared the table of 32. See, 32 ones are 32, 32 twos are 64, 32 threes are 96, 32 fours are 128, 32 fives are 160 and 32 sixes are 192. See, here in the dividend, the first digit is 1 and 1 is smaller than 32. So we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 1. 1 minus 0, 1. Now take down 2, it will be 12. And 12 is smaller than 32. So we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 12. Now subtract it. 2 minus 0, 2. 1 minus 0, 1. Now take down 8. It will be 128. Now 128 is bigger than 32. See, where comes 128 in the table of 32? On 4. 32 fours are 128. So write 4 in the quotient and 128 below the 128. Now subtract it. 128 minus 128, 0. Now take down 4. 4 is smaller than 32. So we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 4. 4 minus 0, 4. So we get the quotient 40 and the remainder 4. Now come to the next question. Here we have to divide 5,586 by 87. So the dividend is 5,586 and the divisor is 87. So first we prepared the table of 87. 87 ones are 87, 82 twos are 174, 87 threes are 261, 87 fours are 348, 87 fives are 435, 87 sixes are 522, 87 sevens are 609. Now let's divide. See, the first digit is 5 and 5 is smaller than 87. So we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 5. 5 minus 0, 5. Now take down 5. It will be 55. Again, 55 is smaller than 87. So we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 55. 55 minus 0, 55. Now take down 8. So it will be 558. So see, where comes 558 in the table of 87? 558 does not come in the table of 87. So check which number is less than and nearest to 558. Which one? 522 on 6. 87 sixes are 522. So we write 6 in the quotient and 522 below the 558. Now subtract it. 8 minus 2, 6. 5 minus 2, 3. 5 minus 5, 0. Now take down 6. So it will be 336. Now check where comes 366 in the table of 87. 366 does not come in the table of 87. So check which number is nearest and less than. Less than to 366. Which one is? 348. Which one? 348 on 4. 87 fours are 348. So we write 4 in the quotient and 348 below the 366. Now subtract it. See, if we subtract 348, so see, 8 we cannot subtract from 6. So we borrow 1 from 6 at the tens place. So this 6 become a 5 and 6 in the unit place become a 16. 16 minus 8, 8. 5 minus 1, 5 minus 4, 1. 3 minus 3, 0. So here we get the quotient 64 and the remainder 18. Now see, come to the next question. Next is 1207 divided by 27. Here the dividend is 1207 and the divisor is 27. For that, first we prepared the table of 27. 27 ones are 27, 27 twos are 54, 27 threes are 81, 27 fours are 108, 27 fives are 135, 27 sixes are 162, 27 sevens are 189. Let's divide. See, in the dividend, the first digit is 1 and 1 is smaller than 27, so we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 1. 1 minus 0, 1. Now take down 2. So it will be 12. Again 12 is smaller than 27, so we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 12. Now subtract it. 12 minus 0, 12. Now take down 2. Now 120 is bigger than 27, so check where comes 120 in the table of 27. 120 does not come in the table of 27, so check which number is less than and nearest to 120. Which one is 108 on 4? So 27 fours are 108. Now subtract it. So see, at the unit place we have to subtract 8 from 0, but we cannot subtract 8 from 0. So we borrow 1 from the tens place. So 2 become a 1 and 0 become a 10. 10 minus 8, 2. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Now take down 7. So it will be 127. Where comes 127 in the table of 27? 127 does not come in the table of 27. Now we will check the number which is less than and nearest to 127. Which one is 108 on 4? So 27 fours are 108. Now subtract it. So 7 minus 8. We cannot subtract 8 from 7. So borrow 1 from the 2. 2 become a 1 and 7 become a 17. 17 minus 8, 9. 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. So here we complete this division. So we get the quotient 44 and the remainder 19. Now see, next 3 questions you have to solve by yourself. This is your homework. Now come to the question number 2. How many hours will it take to travel 336 km at a speed of 48 km per hour? So see, here we have to find how many hours will it take to travel 336 km if its speed is 48 km per hour. So here what information is given? Speed 48 km per hour and total distance 336 km. And see, 48 km per hour means it take 1 hour for 48 km. Means it travel 48 km in 1 hour. And what we have to find, how many hours will it take to travel 336 km. For that, we have to divide 336 by 48. So let's divide it. So the dividend is 336 and the divisor is 48. So for that, first we prepared the table of 48. Now let's divide it. See, the first digit is 3 and 3 is smaller than 48. So we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 3. 3 minus 0, 3. Then take down 3. It will be 33. Again, 33 is smaller than 48. So we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 33. 33 minus 0, 33. Now take down 6. It will be 336. See, where comes 336 in the table of 48? Where? On 7. So 48 sevens are 336. Now we get the remainder 0. So we get the quotient 7 and the remainder 0. So it takes 7 hours to travel 336 km. How many hours? 7 hours. Now come to the next question. Question number 3. See, Griezer needed 35 cartons to pack 1,400 books. There are an equal number of books in every carton. How many books did she pack into each carton? Here, it gives number of cartons and number of books. And what we have to find, how many books did she pack in each carton? See, how many cartons did she require for 400 books? 35. So here we have to find how many books did she pack in one carton. So for that, we have to divide 1,400 by 35. So let's divide it. Here the dividend is 1,400 and the divisor is 35. So first prepare the table of 35. Now let's divide it. See, there is in the dividend first digit is 1 and 1 is smaller than 35. So write down 0 in the quotient and below the 1. 1 minus 0, 1. Then take down 4. Again, 4 is smaller than 35. So write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 14. 14 minus 0, 14. Now take down 0. It becomes 140. Check where comes 140 in the table of 35. On 4. On 4. 35 4 is 140. 140 minus 140, 0. Now if you think here we complete the division. So no, we did not here. The division is not complete because there is one digit left in the dividend. So take down this 0 and write 0 in the quotient and write 0 below the 0. Now subtract it. 0 minus 0, 0. Here we complete the division. So we get the quotient 40. That means she packed 40 books in each carton. How many books? 40 books. Now come to the next question. Question number 4. The contribution for a picnic was 65 rupees each. Altogether 2925 rupees were collected. How many had paid for the picnic? Here what information is given? Here the information is given that they are students and they contribute 65 rupees. Their contribution for picnic was 65 rupees each. Means one student contribute 65 rupees and the total rupees and altogether how many rupees collected? 2925. So here we have to find the number of student, that how many student paid for the picnic. So first we write the information and now see, if we divide 2925 by 65, so we get the answer. So here the dividend is 2925 and the divisor is 65. So for division, first we have to prepare the table of 65 and now divide it. So see here, 2 is smaller than 65. So we write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 2. 2 minus 0, 2. Now take down 9. So it will be 29. Again, 29 is smaller than 65. So, write 0 in the quotient and 0 below the 29. 29 minus 0, 29. Now, take down 2. So, it will be 292. Now, check where comes 292 in the table of 65. See, 292 does not come in the table of 65. So, we will check less than and nearest to 292. So, which one is? 260 on 4. So write 4 in the quotient and 260 below the 292. Now subtract it. 2 minus 0, 2. 9 minus 6, 3. 2 minus 2, 0. Now take down 5. So it will be 325. It will be 325. Check where comes 325 in the table of 65 on 5. 65 5 is 325. Now subtract it. So we get the remainder 0. We get the answer 45. That means 45 had paid for the picnic. How many students? 45 students. See the next three question. Question number 5, 6 and 7. This is your homework. You have to solve by yourself. Here we complete the problem set 15.